Okay, so we are starting now. So if we quickly summarize our previous session, then we have compared gearbox based on arithmetic progression series, geometric progression series, and harmonic progression series. Ultimately, these series are used to find out intermediate distinct RPM in the range of speed. So all these three series, they are giving some different RPMs in entire range of speed of gearbox. We have compared these three and we have concluded that geometric progression series gives us a uniform speeds in range of entire speed range of gearbox. At the same time, we can also go for multi-stage design of gearbox instead of only gearbox between two parallel shafts. We can go for multi-stage design. So we can also utilize radial dimension instead of only using axial dimension. So in that way, structure of gearbox would be like a box type, not a rectangular. So we can utilize proper space. Okay. So because of these reasons, and one another reason is economic loss in cutting speed. If you see in geometric progression series, phi or speed ratio remains constant throughout the range of speed. So if phi remains constant, then as we know, economic loss in cutting speed that depends on phi, which is speed ratio. So in entire gearbox range, loss of economic speed that remains constant, which is not possible in case of harmonic and arithmetic progression series, because phi is continuously varying in the range of speed, right? So due to this all reason, geometric progression is best to use for machine tool gearbox, because in machine tool gearbox we need to go for more than 8 to 10 speeds, right? Now I have also shared one video on demonstration of lathe machine gearbox. I hope you might have seen that video. If it is not yet watched, then you should refer that video. That will give you basic understanding, or that will link actually theory with the practical, right? Now today also we will take reference of that video in today's session. So now we are starting formally design of gearbox, machine tool gearbox. So our first step is to finalizing specifications of gearbox. So primary steps in design of multi-speed gearbox, and it is based on GP, based on geometric progression. Right? So our first step is to find selection of range ratio, which is noted as R suffix capital N. So what is range ratio? Range ratio is nothing but range of speed in which you want to design gearbox. So Rn is ratio of maximum RPM to minimum RPM available from the gearbox, right? So how to find this ratio? If I write spindle speed in terms of cutting speed and workpiece diameter, then N maximum can be written as 1000 times V max, maximum cutting speed, to pi D minimum, because maximum cutting speed represents for some minimum diameter, right? Similarly, N minimum in same form, 1000 V minimum divided by pi D maximum, right? So this is what we have written, spindle speed in terms of cutting speed and workpiece diameter. We are talking about turning operation, so that's a workpiece diameter. Now, if I put these values in this ratio, or simply if I take ratio of these two terms, N max to N min, then I get Rn. So this is what Rn, right? Then what we get? Rn is equals to V max by V minimum into D max by D minimum, right? So I am now defining two new ratio, Rv, which stands for V max to V minimum, and Rd stands for D max D minimum. So Rv is called as cutting speed range ratio, cutting speed range ratio, and Rd is called as diameter range ratio. Okay, so our first step in designing of gearbox is to finalizing or defining speed range, N max to N min. What should be minimum speed available from gearbox, and what should be the maximum speed available from gearbox? So we need to first of all decide speed range, spindle speed range. So that is, now we can say it depends on cutting speed range and diameter range. Now we have already discussed so many times that cutting speed V optimum, that depends on workpiece and cutting tool material combination, right? So you need to first of all define what are the different tools are to be used on machine tool against what are the materials of workpiece. So based on that you can finalize V maximum, V minimum, right? So you need to select range of workpiece materials and range of cutting tool materials, and by using design data book you can find out range of V max to V min. So this is how you can finalize Rv. Now next is Rd. So Rd is diameter range ratio. So diameter range ratio means D max to D min. To understand this, let us consider lathe machine structure then just consider headstock center this is suppose I am presenting chuck here, and this is the axis of spindle, right? On the other side, suppose we have tailstock, tailstock center. So suppose this is tailstock center. And these two are mounted on lathe bed. So this is lathe wheel, right? So if you look this arrangement, then from center this center line or headstock center line to this top of bed, that is what actually defining maximum radius of workpiece which can be operated on lathe machine. So that is actually d maximum by 2. So to define rd, because rd is d max to d minimum, so your lathe structure, this distance, that is half of the maximum possible diameter, radius of the workpiece in short, right? So from this you can finalize, means you need to define whenever you start designing gearbox per particular machine tool, you need to refer machine tool and see what is the possible maximum diameter which can be mounted or which can be operated on that machine tool. So this is about lathe machine. But if you are talking about milling machine, then this can be defined by table width, right? Okay, so this is how you can finalize RD based on the machine tool structure dimensions. So likewise, now we got what should be RV and what should be RD, then you can easily find out, or you can easily define actually RN, right? For reference, one research organization which is called as Machine Tool Research Institute from Russia, they have recommended range, RN range. They have recommended this range based on the RD range. As per this research institute, if you keep RD as 4, then as per their statistics, 85% workpiece can be handled on that particular machine tool if you keep RD as 4. So RD as 4, ratio as 4, you define your D max, then you can easily find out D min. So in this way, and this dimension is, this ratio is suggested by this institute based on the statistics available from globe, right? And they have also suggested a particular range, RN also, for different machine tools. So let us see that range. So for type of machine tool, and what should be the value of RN? What should be the value of range ratio? So first, if we see the general purpose center lathe, because lathe machine is general purpose tool, right? So if any general purpose machine tool if you take, then we need to allow more varieties, because as it's a general purpose tool, then allowable variation would be more in the dimensions as well as in the job material as well as in speed. So due to that, center lathe range for RN, the RN range for center is suggested 40 to 60 for lathe machine, because lathe machine is general purpose tool. So similarly, now if we see other machine tools like boring machine, again it's a general purpose, so 40 to 60. If you go to milling machine, again it's a general purpose, but less general purpose compared to center lathe, so that's why it's a 30 to 50, right? And in that way, if you go for automatic lathe, then they are actually more specific purpose batch lathe machines, so that range is 8 to 10. Similarly, if you see drilling machine, Again, more varieties of object will be handled or required to be handled on drilling machine. That's why range is 15 to 30. RN range is 15 to 30. Similarly, if you take a grinding machine, then grinding machines, they are available in various sizes. So that's why this range is given in 1 to 10. So this is what RN range is suggested for different machine tools by Machine Tool Research Institute, Russia. Okay, so this is how you can find out, or you can define first of all machine tool speed range or the spindle RPM range. So now if we define this RN in terms of, because now we have decided to design gearbox based on GP because of so many advantages available from GP. So that's why RN, let us define RN in terms of geometric progression constant. So N max to N mean, this is in general can be written as NZ, maximum speed to minimum possible speed. Then this as per GP can be written as phi raised to Z minus 1. This equation we have already seen. So this phi is geometric progression constant, or it's a speed ratio between successive speeds, and this Z minus 1. So Z stands for total number of speeds required from gearbox, right? If we write this equation for phi, then I need to give power 1 by Z minus 1 on both the side. Okay, then phi is equals to RN raised to 1 by Z minus 1. So once you finalize RN, then now next two parameters like Z, how many speeds we want and what should be the geometric progression constant. Okay, so our first step is to define speed range. So that is what we discuss, how to decide it. Now next step is select phi. What should be the geometric progression constant for particular machine tool, or the machine tool for which we are designing gearbox, right? So let us write equation of Z, number of speeds. So from this equation, what I need to do? I need to take log on both the side because Z is in power. So let us take log on both the side. Then what we get? Log RN into phi divided by log phi. This is what equation of Z, which is derived from this equation, right? So our first step is to define RN. That is what we discussed. Now our second step is to define phi, how to decide value of geometric progression constant, phi value. And then last we will discuss about Z. So now next is selection of phi. Next is selection of geometric progression ratio, which is nothing but phi. Okay, right? So phi is given based on the preferred number series. So some preferred numbers like R40. You already learned this preferred number in your preliminary design course. So I hope you have basic understanding of this preferred numbers. R20. These are the preferred numbers for deciding phi. R10. Similarly, R20 by 3. R5. R4. in are 20 by 6. So what they tell us, this is 540. Then as per this preferred number, this 540 stands for 10 to the power 1 by 40. 10 to the power 1 by 40. If we find the value, we'll get roughly 1.06. Similarly, this is 520. So 520 stands for 10 to the power 1 by 20. Then it's a 1.12. 510, 10 to the power 1 by 10. It's a 1.26. Likewise, we are writing this all preferred numbers with some numeric value of 5. So, if you look, geometric progression range is given from 1 to 2. So, within this, you need to select 5. If you go for lower value of 5, then more number of intermediate speeds available from particular gearbox. Right? So, that's why this first 2, 1.06 and 1.12, they are recommended for general purpose machine tool. Because in case of general purpose machine tool, more variety of dimension of workpiece as well as work and cutting tool combinations are required. So that's why for general purpose machine tool, this value of 5 is recommended. So, less value of 5, then more number of intermediate speeds available from particular gearbox, right? So, similarly, if you don't have any knowledge of particular machine tool, then blindly you can select 1.26 to 1.58, and that's why this is generally accepted. Generally accepted. But if you already know, we need to give more variation, or we want suppose more speed, then we need to select lower value of 5 so that more number of speed steps available from gearbox. But if you blindly select this value, then ultimately if more speeds available, then you need to go for more gear combination. So size of gearbox keep on increasing as well as cost of gearboxes also keep on increasing if you go for a blind selection of 5. So you need to select properly value of 5. So that's why this is general range. Blindly you can select this. So because it's a midway of this entire range. And the last range is 1.782. This is for special purpose tool. Because in case of special purpose tool, we need to handle limited amount of components. Clear? So that's why more broad range is given. So now if you select higher value of 5, then less amount of intermediate speed steps will be available. Okay? So again, selection is up to the designer. Designer should have knowledge of usage of particular machine tool. If it is general purpose, then go for smaller value of 5. If it is special purpose, then go for higher value of 5. And if the designer is not having proper knowledge or of that machine tool usage, then we can select this range. Okay. And the last one, 1.20. Then previous equation of Z. Now let if I select phi is equals to some value, then what we'll get? Now the third step is to finalize number of speeds available from gearbox. Numbers of speeds available from gearbox, which is nothing but Z. So we have already seen equation of Z in terms of Rn and phi. So from preliminary steps, we know Rn, we know phi, then we can find out Z, right? But if you put here some values and if you take log of that and if you take ratio of that, then Z will never come as an integer value. You get some fraction. Clear? So we need to round off it. And as you round off it, then you should round off it such that it should be a multiplier of 2 and 3. It should be multiplier of 2 and 3. Why? So let's see. Suppose some round off are recommended. So let's see that round off. First of all, range of Z can be round off value of Z. If this ratio comes out to be in range of 5 to 7, then in 5 to 7 range, 6 number can be divided by 2 and 3, right? So 6 can be written as 2 into 3. So that's why if Z value that is in range of 5 to 7, then take round off as 6, because that can be divided into 2 and 3. Similarly, if the Z value is in range of 7 to 8.5, then we know we need to go for 8. If you refer my earlier video on demonstration of lathe machine gearbox, which is from Kirloskar and model is Tun Master 35, then from that model we are getting 8 different RPMs, right? But as we have restricted it into 2 and 3, so if you just refer that video, it was given like 4 into 2, because in first stage we are getting 4 different speeds and in second stage we are getting 2 speeds. So in that way we are getting 4 into 2, total 8 number of speeds. But again, if we go for recommendation, then we should not select 4. We need to go for only 2 and 3. Later we will discuss why only 2 and 3, not for 4 and more values. So later whenever we start design of particular lathe box with some specific case, at that time we'll see what is the effect of taking higher numbers here, right? Now if value of Z that is 8.5 to 10, then again 9 can be divided into 3 as a 3 into 3, right? Similar 10 to 13, then 12 can be divided into 2 into 2 into 3, right? Similarly 13 to 16, then we have 16 which can be divided into 2 raised to 4, right? Okay, so this is what you need to divide and to select value of Z. So if Z value that is in between 5 to 7, then you need to take any number which can be divided into 2 and 3. So this is up to 16. But later stage also, suppose if you go for 16 to 18, then then you need to select 18, because 18 can be divided into 2 and 3 easily without any fraction, right? So that is the selection or the round off of Z value. Okay, so we keep up to this in today's session. Now